currently you can see on the screen. So this is the page you will get once you click on the link. Just click on next. So once you click on next, you can see the eligibility criteria over here, which is given by the company. 2020 full-time graduates only from recognized universities. So later in the application form, there is a list of colleges which can apply for this particular opportunity. Most probably all the colleges are included in that list. So further in the application, you can check if your college is there or not. Okay. So courses or streams, BE BTech, Computer Science and IT. This particular opportunity is only for Computer Science and IT students for BE BTech and MCA. Okay. Check the percentage criteria. You should have minimum of 60% in SSC, HSC and graduation and post graduation. So suppose if you are from MCA, then you need to have 60% in your MCA also. All semesters. Okay. So you should have all semesters 60%. That is what they have mentioned. 60% throughout. There should be no current backlog. So you should not have any live KT or backlog. Education break, maximum 1 year break is allowed. So which is that break? From 10th SSC to highest qualification. So from 10th till your engineering, maximum 1 year break is allowed in your education. Okay. So here are some of the prerequisites. You need to have good written and verbal English skills, flexible to work in any shift, and also they have given the job locations. Okay. So just click here. I have read the eligibility criteria. So they have also told that registration link is open only for students who fulfill ATOS Central's eligibility criteria. So if you don't fulfill the eligibility criteria, probably you won't get the test link. Okay. Click on accept. Once you click on accept, you will get some guidelines before registration. Okay. What you can do, you can just download this particular PDF file so that when you are registering, you can refer to this. Okay. Now see the most important here, some of the instructions. All the text boxes are to be filled in capital. So remember this, you have to fill only in capital. Whichever text box have a asterisk mark, they are mandatory fields. Okay. By selecting on I agree, you are agreeing to the declaration. Okay. So just make sure that the form is compatible with Google Chrome 50 and above. So make sure you are using Google Chrome, Mozilla Firefox or Opera, Safari or Internet Explorer, but all should be latest versions. Okay. You can just download this file and later on when you fill your form, you can refer to this file if you have got any doubt. Click on I have read the instructions and click on next. Okay. So this is the registration form which you will get. We will just check what are the fields on the first page. You need to enter your Aadhaar number which they might require for your identity verification. If you have got PAN, then enter your PAN number. Aadhaar number and PAN number is not compulsory, but I would recommend you to put your Aadhaar number at least. You can put your prefix, first name. Okay. So if you have Aadhaar card, please mention the name as per the Aadhaar card. That is what they have mentioned over here. You can put your middle name, last name, date of birth. Okay. Father's name, mother's first name, primary mobile number. You have to re-enter the mobile number, gender. You have to put your email ID correctly. One important thing over here, you have to validate your email ID. That means once you enter an email ID over here, you have to click on verify email. After clicking on verify email, there will be one code which you will be sent to your email. You have to copy that code and there will be a new text box over here where you have to paste that code. Okay, and verify your email. Put your marital status, mother tongue, current address you need to put properly, city, state. Okay, so legend for the state you can put. Okay, so Maharashtra, then you can put MH. You can put your PIN code. If your current address is same as permanent address, then you can select yes. If no, then you need to again put your permanent address. Okay, because the above one was the current address. Okay, so here you need to put the preferred location for interview. There are a lot of locations which are available, so you can put preferred location for your interview. How did you know about this opportunity? So you can put here nationality Indian. Okay, so once you fill this full page, you can click on next. So this is the way a text box would appear, and you need to check your email where a code will be sent. You need to just paste that code over here and click on confirm code. Once you verify your email, you will get a message like this. Your email has been successfully verified. So on the next page, you have to fill your educational details. If you have done post graduation, click yes. Otherwise, you can click no. Your UG, yes. Currently, you are pursuing. Okay. UG, you are doing full time, part time or correspondence. So you need to fill that. You can select BE BTech. Okay. Current opportunity is only for BE BTech and MCA. So don't select any other option. BE BTech, you have to put your specialization, computer science or IT. Now see, here is the list of colleges which are the students of which are applicable for this particular opportunity, and nearly all the colleges are there in this list. So you need not worry, just find your college and you need to put it in the, you need to select that college. Okay, so you need to select your college, your state where the college is located, your college city. Here you need to enter your aggregate percentage. Okay, it should be above 60. Okay, here they have given one note. In case of CGP or credit system, please convert into percentage as per university or college guidelines. Okay, so if you have got CGPA or credit system in your college, just convert into percentage and put it over here. Okay, here you need to select 2020. Okay. Current backlog none, one or greater than one. Okay. If you have done diploma, then select yes and enter the details of diploma. If you have done 12th, then you need to select yes and enter the details of those. And enter here the details of your 10th standard. Here you need to declare your academic gap. Okay, so no gap, 1 year gap, more than 1 year. Okay, so you need to select appropriately. And after filling all this, just click on next. Once you click next, you will get this page where you have to click. They are asking about your professional experience. So if you have not, don't have any professional experience, you can just click fresher. If you have done any internship, then you can mention here, okay, 0 to 12 months or you have done any internship, okay. If you have not done any specific internship or notable thing, then just click fresher. Here you need to upload your CV, click on I agree to terms and click on submit. So once you click on submit, you will get here, thank you for registering for Syntellect 2020. Your submission has been received. You will also get your candidate ID. One important note, only eligible candidates or applicants will be allowed to participate in the campus recruitment drive as per the campus eligibility criteria by ATOS Syntel. Okay, so this is very important. So only if you are satisfying the eligibility criteria, then you can apply and then only you will be able to participate. Okay, currently some basic questions which you might ask after watching this video. What is the package, pay package? The pay package is not declared by the company currently, but you can just search some of the website where you will get some average package which is offered by ATOS Syntel for freshers. Maybe it would be around 3.5 lakhs, but I'm not sure about the exact pay package. Okay. Another question you might ask, what is the last date to apply? The last date to apply is not mentioned anywhere by the company. Maybe you might get a similar mail or link from your training and placement head. So you can apply as soon as possible before waiting for the last date. Okay, so thank you for watching the video. Don't forget to like this video if you have liked the way we are giving you the information of various opportunities. And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel, since we'll be posting many such opportunities of off-campus drives, and also we'll be updating various placement preparation videos. Thank you.